Welcome to you all in this session, and you already have the idea that today we are going to discuss facet design pattern. Facet design pattern is one of the very easy and very effective design pattern. Very first, we will try to understand the situation in which this design pattern is used. Suppose you are having a very complex API system that is created with the help of multiple classes, and you need to perform multiple or a single task that is dependent on some calculation that is done inside those classes. In this condition, what facet design pattern do for you is, it gives you a kind of interface to deal with that complex API system. You have simple functions through which you can perform all of your tasks, and you need not to worry about the complexity that is enwrapped inside those classes. This solution is provided with the help of facet class, in which all the required logical calculation and interaction among the API classes is done, and a function is provided as an interface to get the desired output. So in facet design pattern, your calling component interacts only with the method that is provided by the facet class. It need not to interact with all those classes that are involved in particular logical calculation. So this way, facet design pattern simplifies all the complexity required in the calculation inside that particular layer. Now you understand the structure and the use case of facet design pattern. So next step is to implement it practically. So open your Xcode and get ready for it. The example that we are taking here is little bit exaggerated, but it will help you in understanding the implementation of facet design pattern in an easy way. Suppose you have to implement a system that calculates the cost of complete mission, and that cost is dependent upon type and location of the enemy and the type of troop involved in completing that mission. So lots of complexity, right? So this complete system is implemented with the help of three classes. First is enemy map, second is ship, and third one is troop. Enemy map is the class that is responsible for providing the location of enemy in the form of map location object, where map location is a struct, and that is having two properties, grid letter and the grid number. Enemy map class is having only one function, that is find enemy, and which provide the map location object according to the enemy type. Second class in your system is ship, that is representing the actual ship for your mission. The location of ship is represented with the help of struct ship location, that is having two properties, north south and east west. And whenever you are going to start a new mission, then the ship position is initialized with the help of ship location struct by giving 5 as an argument for north south and the east west properties. Move location is the function that is imitating the movement of your ship, and every time when you get the target enemy location, your ship takes some time to reach to the target location, and once it reaches to the target, with the help of callback, it notifies to the system that ship has been reached to the target location. Last class in our system is troop, where a troop can perform three type of action. First is shooting, second is using missile, or third is use of tank. All these three actions are represented with the help of enum actions. Our troop class is having one function, perform action. With the help of that, we can calculate the cost that is involved for the particular action in any mission. Now the problem statement is, every time when a new mission type come to you, then you have to tell the expected cost of that particular mission. So whenever you are calculating the cost of any mission, then the complexity of all the three classes are involved every time. You need to know what is the location of enemy, you need to know what kind of enemy you are going to have, and what kind of troop you need to engage to complete that particular mission. And also you need to consider that how much time your ship will take to reach to the enemy location. So all these factors will be involved whenever you are going to calculate the complete cost of that particular mission. So solution of this particular situation, we will use facet design pattern in implementing the facet class. This class will be having only one function, getMissionCost, that will take care all the parameters that is required in calculating the cost of complete mission. Right now, you need not to worry about the coding implementation of this function, because our purpose is to make you understand the situation where this design pattern is used and how you can implement this as a facet class. So if you want to have the code files, then just write your email ID in the comment box and we will send you the complete zip file for the code. So this is the get mission cost function that is having complete complex logic of calculating the mission cost. And at the last, it is returning you the mission cost. So with the help of facet class, we have summarized all the complexity of all the classes that is required to calculate the mission cost. And this is the real benefit of the facet design pattern. You need not to worry about underlying classes that is required for the logical calculation. Just you need to deal with the facet class for getting the required output. So this is the beauty of facet design pattern. Here we end this session on facet design pattern. For any of the code sample, just you need to provide your email ID in comment box. Next, we will learn about adapter pattern. So stay tuned with us and happy learning.